Folks, a minor miracle has occurred. Apparently, these guys deserve a huge shout out. The pickup wizard. You need your pickup rewound? Check them out. Unbelievable service. It's like back. So I'm going to pop this in. Oh, one more screw. One more screw. Sunshine's popping in the window. I gotta get out of here. That's why I'm doing this early. I was gonna do it late, but then it got too late. Out you come. Very nice. Okay, give me a minute. Yeah, I got the wind machine going. Because that's what I need to do. You can do it, Davey. You can freaking do it. Gee, guys. Could have given me a little more wire. But anyway, I'm not going to complain. Nobody's listening anyway. When you do complain. Alright. That ain't never going to work. That ain't never gonna work. Because it ain't never gonna work, Dave. Now it's gonna work. Wonderful. Let's jam it back in, see what happens. Well, folks, I think maybe the pickup wizard wasn't such a wizard this time, because we have coming off the pickup three wires. Here, I'll try and zoom in a little bit. Three wires. This shielded one is connected to the case. Obviously, that needs to be grounded. Then we have the two wires, which are the coil of the actual windings. So, if we hook one of those wires to ground and the other one to hot, this thing should make a noise. But it don't make shit, guys. So, gee, I don't know what the... I get a hum. Nothing coming out of that. You put a continuity meter across. You know, okay, we'll do beeping first, right? Where are we here? Hope you can hear it. Okay, so the case should be grounded. Right? Now, if I go across the black and the white wires that have shielding on them, I should hear a beep. And I get nada. Nothing. And if I try to measure the pickup, nothing. Okay. Well, I'll have to contact the happy guy that spent all the shipping sending this pickup. And I can tell someone's been in it. I can see where the glue was broken and then it was re-glued back together. It's got a new lead on it, but it doesn't make a sound. Look, guys, it came back. The pickup wizard. We almost had to use his name in vain, but other than a bunch of extraneous shipping costs, we seem to have rewound the pickup in question that was rewound once. Anyway, pickup wizard. The guy got her back fast as snot both times. But we're just going to measure some impedance to see if
the pickup wizard actually succeeded.
Like I said, I apologize for the fan, but it's hot. We're making fumes. What we'd like to see is a resistance of 8.5 kΩ across those coils. And right now, look at that, 8.52. And if we do a continuity, because it is a coil, it should beep through, right? Right? Are you guys? Nope. Oh, I'm not there. Wait a minute. That's a stupid meter. I'm getting a new one. It's on the slow boat from you know where. There we go. Fantastic. How could it be any better? Like, really? How could life get any better? Let's make it do what it's supposed to do. Just gotta look one more time. Oh, wrong setting. Here we go. Look at that. Wow. I know you guys like to see everything that goes on. So, what am I looking for? A couple of springy things and two pickup screw things. We'll get all that together. And, you know. So while I'm on the topic of things that matter, okay, if you sent me money for a sticker and you didn't get your sticker, please make sure you sent me your address. Right? Next, I'm going to pause for a minute. I'm going to get the document. Okay. This came today from the War Amps. Okay? These are the labels that I use when I send you guys stickers and soon t-shirts. But anyway, we're just, you know, there's some little bit of disrespect and stuff about what goes on with these guys, and it's like, the War Amps does not use professional. This is a Canadian charity, so I'm sorry to everybody around the world, but this is one of ours. They don't use professional fundraisers. They don't get any government grants. They don't call you on the fucking phone or come door to door. Sell or trade your name or address. Spend more than 10% on administration. Tie up funds in long-term investments. Okay, so you guys can look up what they do. But anyway, here's the challenge, guys. Because that's a whole big whack of return. And look what they say this time. Look what they say. Dave's World of Fun Stuff. See? You gotta love these guys. I asked. They did it. And that's my next donation. So I want you guys to step up, get a sticker every time you get one. One of those goes on it. And it helps the channel. And it makes some other people happy that deserve it more than us. That's all I'll say. Let's get this pickup in here. I know you guys are getting the full sound wave of the fan, but I can't suck the fumes anymore, guys. Get a little protection. There we go. So I've been told 1975. This thing Ibanezed everybody. Tin those guys up. And memory serves me right. Really would like a tiny bit more solder on that wire. Just cause. See, even with the fan, I'm still blowing it. It's like, fuck you. wires are tinned. That went cold on me because I moved it. Wires are tinned. All you gotta do is hit it. I lost a bit of solder. Stand by. You know, and even with the fan noise in the background, I just wanna really just take a minute to thank everybody. I'm blown away by the enthusiasm, response, and support. So again, if the wires are 10, and the terminal is 10, it's just this, I don't know about this Japanese solder. Okay, we'll run with that. Stand by for a test. And I do apologize for any technical shit that's going on, because I think it's time for all new stuff, guys. Okay, there it is. Both and the back. Nice. Yeah. I'm finished soldering. I'll turn off the thing. But seriously, thanks to everybody for the support. Oh, wait till you see the surprise I have to go with this. This is... this is like the ball washer of this repair. Not only did we clean a million years of shit off the guitar and get a pickup rewound. Wait till you guys see this. I'm looking for another screw in. Oh, there it is. Wait a minute. Don't be that guy. Oh, there it is. They're in there. Yeah. Wait till I show you this. This will be the best. Okay, remember, someone was so ashamed and, you know, humble that they really wanted to fool somebody that was a Rickenbacker. Okay, but what we have is an original truss rod cover that says Ibanez. And we put a new knob on it, so we cleaned it all up and we straightened the neck. Need a little pickup height adjustment there, I can tell, but these have balls out, man. This is like balls out. I'm serious. Okay, let's do a little bit of setting up and get out of here.
This will be the over-the-shoulder boulder holder camera angle. All right, what could go wrong? What was I doing? Okay, remember the truss rod, you know, and I cranked the shit out of it, and everybody got pissed off at me, and, you know. You guys realize by now, I really don't give a shit. Rule number one. Never work on a guitar that you can't just hand the money over for if you destroy it. Although there'd be some crying, there's really nothing else to do. It's just like, I'm very sorry I destroyed your guitar. Here's the money. Have another one. I didn't kill your baby. It's just a machine. Do people get that? It's just a machine! It's like paint in a tube. For an artist, this is like, there's some paint. Wow, that's really nice paint. I can't paint a fucking picture, but that's really nice paint. Anyhow, yeah, enough of that. What could have happened here? Like, the neck? Nah, she just still ain't straight enough. I'm sorry. Let's see what can happen. Well, that was a fist fight. But I sort of got another half a turn out of it, but... don't think it's really where you'd want it to be. Well, just about. Frick with it anymore. Come on, capo. And I just wanted to say, this is the biggest, fattest, like, this is like a pea base neck on a Rickenbacker. If, like, so if you're wondering what it plays like, it isn't like a Rickenbacker. It's all fat and... Okay, what else do I want to do? I want to try and check the intonation. I'd like to look at the pickup height, but I know it's wrong. Excuse the magnifier. But it's just wrong. Well, you know what? I'm going to call it acceptable. It's not where I'd like it to be. E string needs to come down a bit. A string's fine. D string's wrong. G string. So we got this. And there's no way to correct that individually without filing the slots. So I guess that's what we're going to do. Yep, here we are. In the land of the guessing game. Because we're in the land of guessing game Rickenbacker. See, then you get to take a little bit. Tune it back up. You don't want to take too much off. Then you're the goof. We're going to have a look. I know you can't see, but I'm going to tell you. It is fantastic. Next is the D string, which doesn't like us. You know, and don't try this at home, folks, without the right stuff. You will rat fuck your shit. You see how that, how meticulous and like, that's all feel, guys. How did you know how much to take off, Dave? Because I knew not to take off too much. 64s. Yoda says, learn the law of 64s. Let's have a look. Let's see what Yoda has to say. Here we can do this with the camera. Boom! That. Well, look. We're almost there. Almost there. Where all the strings are the same height across the fretboard. You know. Okay, what am I looking for? I'm looking for a 60. That's gonna be it, ladies and gents. So, you know, once again, it would have played like ass. All the strings were different heights. So as much as you try, you ain't gonna win. It's gonna not feel right. There we go, and I would almost take a couple more shaves off that guy. I think I'm gonna. So at this point, we really say a prayer for intonation, because as I pointed out, well,
This one's not as bad as the Rickenbacker. I can actually see the screws, so I could move the string and move it. But most of the times on a Ricky, when you get the string action nice and low, those screws are buried down in that extrusion, and you have to loosen everything and lift it up. Like, just cornhole me. Okay, I'm removing the condom. Look at that. Don't be that guy. Look, there's a little Gucci thing. So this is a nicely made aftermarket. Nicely done, guys. So now we'll play Rubik's Cube. Maybe, I think, there you go. That's it. And of course the fucking screw holes don't line up. Oh well. Guess what we're doing next? Yeah, baby. Some sort of Ibanez Rickenbacker thing brought back to life. Compliments of me, and posterity lives on. Subscribe, Twitter me, Facebook me, become a patron, buy a sticker, help me out. I love all yous. Cheers.